Welcome back to Poppins Approved. I have here the brand new spring collection colors from Fawn Design. Well, I actually have two of the three colors. There is a coral color, sea glass, and then also a sand. So what I wanted to show you guys today is the pretty coral color here. This is in the original size. I just got these in the mail, so I haven't even like taken off all of the packaging, but I just kind of wanted to hurry quickly, get this video out for you guys so you guys could see the different colors. So this one is a beautiful coral color, and then also in the brand new mini, which has some really cool new features, which I'll explain in a minute, I have the sea glass color, and that one is also this really pretty kind of light green color. I'm really excited that they decided to make all of their spring 2019 collection bags in the matte leather. Most of their like original colors are all in the pebbled leather, and I just don't like that one as much. I feel like a lot of people have been giving them that feedback, and so I think that's why they decided to make all of their colors this spring in the matte, because it just feels so soft and squishy and nice, and things just kind of slide in and out easily because of the smooth leather. Now, originally when I first grabbed these bags, I thought that I was going to be in love with this sea glass color. Felt like a kind of neutrally green. But now that I have both of them, the coral color has kind of stolen my heart. Not that the sea glass isn't pretty, I just wasn't expecting to like this one more than this one. And I think I was expecting this sea glass one to be a tiny bit of a lighter color, or maybe not lighter is the right word. Maybe I thought there was a tiny bit more of a hint of like bluish in it, but it's definitely a really pretty light green. I think on both of the bags, the gold hardware complements the colors really nicely. So overall, I'm really happy with these colors. The most important thing that I wanted to kind of talk about for this video is going to be the new features for the Fawn Design mini bag. First of all, it's an inch wider and an inch taller so that you have a little more space in here, which is amazing. I always have felt that the mini was just like a little bit too small and it could use a little more room. So I love that they've added more space. That's awesome. And then they have added the grab handle here, and a whole back pocket where you can tuck in your backpack straps, and this extra back zippered pocket that goes all the way across. I've just kind of thrown all my stuff into the larger bag really quickly, and I want to kind of unpack that for you and show you what will fit into the mini version now that it is a little bit bigger. So let's get started. Okay, you guys, here are the bags side by side. You can see that obviously the original is a lot bigger than the mini version, but I still wanted to kind of take the things out of here and see what I can fit into the mini bag. I love the newer version of the original size is able to fit large water bottles. So my larger water bottle fits there for sure. It will not fit into these side pockets on the mini, but I do wanna see if someone wanted to bring water with them and they didn't need a ton else. It will fit just kind of sitting in here. If you wanted to put some things next to it, it'll close, no problem. So if you do need to bring a water bottle with you and you just want to use this as like a purse or something, you are able to fit about a 24-ounce water bottle. Moving on to some of the other pockets, in here I have a coin purse and then also my wallet. I think I'm going to put those in this very back section. Oh, here is the messenger strap that comes with the bag. I think for right now, I will just put that at the very bottom. And then I'm going to put this inside of this little back pocket here. And then in the front zippered area, I'm just keeping some lip products. So I think I'll try and put those in the same spot right here on this bag. That fits no problem. Turning to the side here, I do have my cell phone. It is a snug fit, but it does fit and I don't mind it being in that pocket. And then on the back here, let's see what I have in this zippered pocket. I think I'm just keeping wipes. So I have some wet ones and then some underarm deodorant wipes. I think I'll try and do the same thing. I'll put those in this back zippered area. I love that this is wider now. I can definitely fit more here already. So back here, I just have a calendar and then also a Kindle. So I don't know if the calendar will fit. Let's see. Let's see if this calendar will fit. It fits fine in the back of the original, but let's see if it fits in the mini. It won't fit. Oh, yeah. It's a little tiny bit
wide. Oh, but it will fit. I can't actually get it in there. Okay, cool. I didn't think that was going to fit. So that actually fit in there. It's a tiny bit tight, but it works. And then I'll put the Kindle in there as well. Plenty of room back there for that. This is the new Kindle Paperwhite, just to show you kind of for size reference what that looks like back there. Tons and tons of space back there now, which is awesome. Let's move on to the interior of the coral bag. I really love that pop of color inside that coral. It's so pretty. In this back section, I have a notebook. I also have some earphones. I think I'm actually gonna put the earphones here on this front, in that front pocket. And then I'm gonna take the little notebook and maybe just add it to that pocket with my wallet and the coin purse. I love that with this bucket style kind of bag, you can just look in and see everything that you need easily. Just to kind of give you a better idea of the pockets, I'll remove the items from the center. So right here I have a large set piece with diapers and wipes and also some baggies, dirty diapers, and then also a wet bag in here. So lots of things in there. And then I also have a travel on packing cube. I think this is the medium size, but I just have a few snacks in here. Now you can really see all the pockets. You have a zippered pocket here on the front, and then you have four slip pockets going around the front wall of the bag and the sides. And then you have this little key clip here, which I'm going to just put my keys on the same exact little key clip on the mini. I did want to point out that the mini has the same exact pockets. The only difference is there's no zippered pocket here like there is on the original version. In this back zippered pocket, I am keeping my different like pens and my Tide2Go pen. And I think I'm actually gonna put those into this side pocket here. They kind of fit perfectly there height-wise. If you have some Itsy Ritsy snack pouches, these little ones, these fit perfectly inside of these side pockets. In case you're looking for different pouches to use, these ones fit really great. This one has all of my like medical needs and mommy stuff. I have some floss, I have some hand sanitizer, lotion, I have nail clippers, and then I'm also keeping like Band-Aids and sunscreen, all that good stuff inside of this little pouch. And then in this next one, I am keeping squigs for the kids to play with when I need them to be busy. So I wanted to see if these pouches, because they're such a good little size, if they would fit inside of these pockets on the mini. I have always found that these pockets on the mini are really, really small and they're hard to like fit anything in. So I don't think they're gonna fit on the side ones because those seem smaller, but the front ones here, yeah, the front ones will fit these little snack bags from Itsy Ritsy. But when these pockets are filling up, it kind of makes the space in the middle unusable. Let's see if I can fit my snacks there because I know I need my snacks. I mean, I can barely, that barely fits right there, which is fine. So snacks will go right there. I have a couple more things in here. On the front wall, I have this Dagny Dover pouch. And then I'm also keeping a Travelon packing envelope with Twistables crayons. I have another little pouch that has all my receipts, and then I have my checkbook. Inside of the Dagny Dover pouch, I'm just keeping boogie boards for the kids and then also some like flashcards to work on. So let's see if any of this stuff will fit. Since the receipts and the checkbook are so thin, I think I'm gonna try and put those just in the very back as well. They fit fine there. I do still have these crayons. I don't need these all the time, but just for the sake of the video to see if it will fit, let's just kind of put them. Let's see if they'll fit in this side pocket over here. That barely fits over there into that slip pocket. I still have this slip pocket over here open, but I don't know if I could fit anything in there. It would have to be something small. This whole thing is definitely not going to fit, so I'm actually just gonna remove the wipes because I know I'll need those for sure. I think the baggies actually might be able to fit into that side pocket I was just saying I had empty, so that worked. And then I'll just grab one diaper and my wipes and I will just slip those down in right next to the snack bag. I mean, I could just kind of sit that in here, I think, and it would close. So I guess that would work. But to make it a little more functional, maybe I'll just grab out one of the boogie boards. So you can see the boogie board's gonna go there. I have the Kindle right here, and then I have my calendar right there in front. I'm gonna kind of snap that closed. It is really tight right now, but I'm kind of amazed that all of this is actually fitting. Before, I could definitely not fit this much stuff, but you can see these outer pockets here are getting really, really tight. It's gonna be hard to kind of squeeze this stuff in and out, so you probably don't wanna pack this way all of the time. I was just curious about the capacity of it. So I know I didn't have the original all the way full, but those are like the mainly the things that I would normally take. Kind of shocked that this packed, that this was able to pack so much. The only thing that didn't fit was the larger water bottle, which if you didn't have this much stuff, you could fit that on the interior. And then I did have a few more things like a wet bag and then a couple more size 5 diapers. So I was only able to bring one diaper and my set of wipes. But if you're using this for a quick trip, I think that's totally fine. Last thing, I also was not able to bring the extra boogie board and the flashcards. All in all, that is a pretty good amount of stuff. And it zips up, no problem. You do have that extra space on top if you did have like a little lovey blanket or some kind of like burp cloth or something that would fit there just fine. So having that grab handle is going to be a game changer for sure. I also did want to mention that the backpack straps on the mini are a little bit thinner than they are on the original. I do think that the original is a little more comfortable with the wider strap. But if you don't pack this too heavy, I think that these straps are gonna work just fine. I love that now it's the same as the original where you can detach these straps here and tuck them into the back of this back pocket in case you just wanna wear the bag messenger style without those backpack straps flopping around. So that is an awesome new addition. Okay, now let's see what these bags look like on the body. Helpful if you're curious about what the new colors look like and also the new features on the mini bag. As always, if you have questions, leave them in the comments below. Like I said, if I had to choose one of the colors between the two, I'd probably go with the coral. Thank you guys for hanging out with me for this review today, and we will talk to you guys next time.